Hello everyone, welcome to Andy Visits. In today's video, we'll be discussing about the movie Bad Boys for Life and the mid-credit scenes and how it sets up the future. If you are a fan of Bad Boys series, then you have been waiting an awfully long time for a third installment. Bad Boys 2 came out back in 2003, so it's been basically a generation since we have seen Mike Lowery and Marcus Burnett on the big screen. If you had a kid around the time last movie came out, they are basically old enough to watch an R-rated movie without you now. Expectations were certainly high for the long gestating movie, and it has to be said, Bad Boys for Life certainly did its best to blow us away. If not with its action, then with the way its plot takes some serious turns. So we learned during the film that Will Smith's character Mike Lowery was pulled directly from the police academy prior to the first film in the series for a special undercover mission. He was embedded with a Mexican drug cartel when he fell in love with Isabel, the wife of the cartel's leader. Mike did his job and let the cartel go down, including Isabel, but it was apparently a difficult choice for him to make because he was truly in love with her at that time. What's more, we learn that Isabel went to prison pregnant, and the child she gave birth to, the one who has been on a personal vendetta against Mike and killed several other people, is actually Mike's own son, who he never knew he had. This was some serious telenovela shit. So in the end, the son Armando helps Mike rescue Marcus and nearly dies himself, but is instead arrested and imprisoned for his crimes. That could be the end of the story, but it's not. The mid-credits scene. Shortly after the credits roll on Bad Boys for Life, we are treated to one additional scene. We see Armando in love as Mike comes to visit him. Mike also asks how he's doing, and while Armando certainly doesn't love being locked up, he seems to have come to terms with his situation. He knows that he committed crimes and is prepared to pay his debt for having done so. However, Mike has apparently came for more than just small talk. He has something which he believes might aid Armando, some sort of deal which Mike says might help his son pay down his debt. We don't learn exactly what this offer is, but one assumes it's some sort of agreement which will allow Armando to get himself free sooner by helping out the Miami police. Clearly, it's a tease for another Bad Boy movie. So what it means for the future? While Bad Boys 3 has been one of those movies that's been talked about since basically the last one came out, there was a point a few years back when the talk turned from something more theoretical to something more real. In fact, at one point there was a plan to film not just a third Bad Boys film, but a fourth film as well. While the fourth film has since been dropped from Sony's release calendar, it seems quite clear from this setup that the plan is still to make at least one more movie in the franchise, which will be used, at least in part, as a redemption arc for Mike Lowery's kid.